I've got my SAN storage set up, as you see here, for shared storage, and it's connected into node 1 using the iSCSI target service on shared storage and the iSCSI initiator service on node 1, which is called file server 1. Now what I want to do is I want to install failover clustering, and then I'm going to set up my first cluster. I'm in file server 1. And I'm going to go into Server Manager, Add Roles and Features. And we get a wizard that pops up. I'll click Next. And I'm just going to keep clicking Next until I get to the Features section. First, I need to select my server, File Server 1. And then it will just continue on past Server Roles and then to Features, which is where we'll find our failover clustering. So there's the option right there. I'll choose to add the features that need to go with it. Click Next and install. I'm also going to install the same feature on node number 2. And once those two are installed, we can go ahead and set up the first cluster in Server Manager under the Tools menu. If you missed any of the previous videos where I explain what Windows clustering is, why we need it, and also setting up the storage, then just go ahead and check out those videos in this playlist. Failover clustering has been installed. I need to restart in order to continue. So I'll just go ahead and do that, and then we'll jump back in. Now I'm using this on virtual machines for both nodes, but you can do them on physical or a combination. So now what we want to do is we want to go into Tools and Server Manager and go to Computer Management and make sure that the servers are in each other's administrator groups. So I'm going to click on Local Users and Groups, Groups, and then go to Administrators. Now I'm going to add in the two computers into File Server 1. So I'll click on Object Types, click Computers. Then we want to say the location is the Active Directory. That's fine. So we'll type in File Server 1 and File Server 2. Next, we'll go into File Server 2 and perform the same task. Then we'll switch back to File Server 1, where we're going to create our cluster and then move forward. The permissions have been added. Now I'm going to go into Tools in Server Manager and go to Failover Cluster Manager. And here we will create our cluster. I'm going to right-click where it says Failover Cluster Manager and choose Create Cluster. And we get this wizard that comes up, so we'll just walk through it one step at a time. Enter the server name. So what this is all about is we want to enter the two servers that will be our nodes in our cluster. And File Server 2 is now added into our cluster as a new node. I'll click Next. Now the next thing we want to do is to choose between running the configuration validation test before or after. I'm going to choose not to because I'm going to do a different video just on these validation tests and how you can use it to keep your cluster running well as fix any issues. Now we need to come up with a cluster name, and this is really important because we also need to come up with an IP address that's not being used by any other computer in our network. I checked and we're not using the name cluster, so that works out. And my IP address is going to be 192.168.21.201, which is an IP address on our subnet that's not being used by anything else. So I'll click Next. And now we see that we're ready to create the cluster. So I'll click Next, and now it's going to take a few minutes to create the cluster. Now there's always a possibility that you run into some errors at this point. And if that happens, you'll definitely want to run those configuration tests prior to this point. And we were successful in creating the cluster, so I'll click Finish. And the upper left-hand section here, we see our cluster showing up. There it is. Take a look at the nodes. We should see File Server 1 and 2, and there they are. They're both up and running. Fantastic. And under Networks, we see the network is up as well. And if I click on the network, we can see that the subnet is 21.0/24. Click on Network Connections, we can see that both File Server 1 and 2 have their Ethernet connections up and running. And we can certainly expand that to see what IP addresses those guys are. Let's take a look at the cluster events just to see what the event log has been showing. And this is good news, there's nothing there because you're only going to see errors and problems. You're not going to see anything good that's happening with the cluster in these events. Now if we go to roles, can see that there really are no roles yet, and there's no specific storage yet. So we go to storage, we go to disks, and there's nothing there. So at this point, all we've done is create the cluster. We've added the nodes. So now in this playlist, you're going to see a lot of videos on adding storage, different types of storage, adding different roles, so you can have different applications and file shares and virtual machines, things like that. So take a look at the playlist, pick out the ones that you need to watch, and we'll continue on, and you'll be able to get the help that you need for your cluster.